In the previous production diary, Tell Me a Story, we changed the whole concept, setting the project some 150 years in the future. As such, it will help to establish the location of stars and planets where all the action will take place. Let's see how we can use Blender to help visualize star systems. There are two basic ways to model star charts: randomly place spheres as stars, put a few smaller ones around them, and call them whatever you want. Or, in the interest of trying to keep things as real and believable as possible, one could plot each actual star that has had planets discovered. In order to do that, I needed some actual data. Now, it took a bit of searching, but with sites such as the University of Puerto Rico and the NASA Exoplanet Archive, I was able to download a lot of data. Clearly, for my story purposes, I needed to limit the data a fair bit. As such, I set a maximum distance of 30 parsecs from our sun, since the story is only around 150 years in the future and I figured humanity wouldn't have branched out too far. Given that the whole idea would be to locate and colonize Earth-type planets, I figured stars much like ours would be more likely to have livable planets. Sol, the actual name of the sun, is a G-class star, so thinking that any stars on either side of that could be viable, the list was further limited to F, G, and K-class stars. This resulted in a much more manageable list, with some specific data of individual planets in orbit around those stars. Filtering for just each star, we can get a fairly simple list of general star names, its location relative to the sun, and its radius compared to the sun. With the goal being to visualize it all in Blender, we basically have two options: manually add a UV sphere for each star and move it to the listed location, or write a script in Python and read the list and automatically create each sphere object. My only problem is that I can't code to save myself. Given the potential to make use of some of the other data and being able to generate a star chart with a click of a button, using Python seemed to be the best option. Turns out others thought the same, and a quick internet search turned up a Reddit post with a good outline of what I wanted to do. For an initial test, I created a basic text file with just the position and radius of three stars, as per the same code. Then, starting up Blender, deleting the default cube and switching to the scripting workspace, I clicked on New and pasted in the sample code. With the sample code being 9 years old, it seemed that the syntax for the open file function had changed a little and not helped by my long file path. On running the script, it worked and I got three spheres. However, we do have a bit of a problem in that for stars, they are rather large. Not that the stars are exactly small, but they are also very close to each other. The problem isn't that the data is wrong, it's that I'm treating it all as the same unit of measurement, which of course it isn't. This is where we employ a little artistic license to create something that looks right. By multiplying the radius by 0.2, we can shrink the size of each star, leaving us with something a bit more believable. Returning to our longer list of stars, we also have a name for each one, which would be better than sphere, sphere 01, etc. By making a couple of changes, we can name each sphere as it is created. First, we need to adjust the list variable reference by 1, as the name is now temp 0 rather than the x location of the object. And second, we add a new line that takes the star name from the list and applies it as each new object is created. Running the script, and within a second, we really do end up with something that looks like a star chart with our sun in the center and each object named. However, we have a big problem. Looking at the data, HIP21421 has a radius value that is just massively larger than any other star. Chances are this is correct, and it's the mishmash of unit measurements that is making it all look wrong. For now, we will just scale it down by 0.1 so that it is still larger than any other star, but not consuming a quarter of the screen. From this point, we could dive deeper into the data, like the number of planets each star has, and see what else we can generate either by code or using new features like geometry nodes. But for now, this proves I can take a collection of real astronomical data and use Blender to visualize where the story takes place, while at the same time starting to create elements that will no doubt end up in the final animation. If you like this look behind the scenes and want to see more, or have specific questions or requests, then please click the usual YouTube buttons and or leave a comment below. If not, that's perfectly fine, and I hope to see you for the next one. Cheers!